गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द लेंस फार्मूला एंड मैग्निफिकेशन। द फार्मूला विच कनेक्ट्स द और विच रिलेट्स द ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस यू, इमेज डिस्टेंस वी एंड द फोकल लेंथ ऑफ अ लेंस, दैट इज कॉल्ड द लेंस फार्मूला। सो इट इज गिवन बाय 1 एफ इज इक्वल टू 1/v माइनस 1/u, where u is equal to object distance, v is image distance and f is focal length. So this is called lens formula. This is different from the mirror formula. There you have your negative positive sign and here you have negative sign, and it is v first and then u. Now, as I discussed earlier, the object distance is always taken negative and focal length it is taken positive for convex lens and negative for concave lens. So this was the mirror formula. Now next, let us define the magnification. So magnification produced by any lens is the actually extent up to which the image of the object is magnified by a lens, spherical lens. Mathematically, it is defined as the ratio of the size of the image to the size of the object. So, if we suppose that u is the size of h dash is the size of the image and h is the size of the object, then magnification, which is represented by small m, mathematically can be written as m is equal to h dash upon h, where h is equal to object size, height, and h dash is image height or size. Now this is the magnification in terms of the size of the object and size of the image. Now in terms of u and v, object distance and image distance, it is defined as the ratio of v and u, that is image distance to the object distance. So this was the lens formula and magnification. Now let us discuss the next topic, that is the power of a lens. Power of a spherical lens. So how can we define the power of a spherical lens? Actually, it is the degree of convergence or divergence. Power of lens is actually the degree of convergence or the divergence. That is, power of lens tells us to what extent the lens converges the object or to what extent the lens diverges the object. Mathematically, it is defined as the reciprocal of the focal length of any spherical lens. So, if f is the focal length of any spherical lens and the power be represented by capital P, So mathematically it is 1 by f. Now the unit of this optical power is for electrical power, mechanical power you have the same symbol capital P. Here it is the optical power. So its unit is diopter, D-I-O-P-T-R, diopter, and represented by capital D. For getting the power in diopter, this F should be in meter. That is, here F is in meter. If the focal length is not given in meter, if it is given in centimeter, then you have to first convert the focal length into meter, then you put here in the formula. Otherwise, you will use this formula for the power 100 upon F. If F is in centimeter, then you will use this formula. Now, suppose that there are not one or two lenses, there are so many lenses. So, what will be the focal length of the combination of lenses and what will be the power of the combination of lenses? So, let us find out combination of lenses. Combination of lenses. If we have two or more than two lenses, suppose one convex lens, another concave lens, then again concave lens. We have many devices like camera. We have there the telescope, microscope, the eyepiece consists of many lenses. So we have assembly of lenses. So what is the net power? What is the focal length of the assembly of lenses, or what is the power of the assembly of lenses? How do we determine? So if suppose this has focal length F1, this has focal length F2, this has focal length F3, three lenses, then there is a formula to find the what is the focal length of this assembly of three lenses. There is a formula 1 by F is equal to 1 upon F1 plus 1 upon F2 plus 1 upon F3. So we put F1, F2 and F3 with sign. That is, if first lens is convex, here we will put the focal length positive. Here we will put the focal length negative. Here we will put the focal length negative. Similarly for n lenses, this formula extends for n lenses. So 1 by Fn. Now, how does this three lenses or four lenses, this assembly of lenses we have? The assembly of lenses will be have depending on the sign of the effective focal length. If effective focal length F comes out to be, after solving, comes out to be positive, it means the three lenses or four lenses, they are behaving like a convex lens. If the effective focal length comes out to be the negative, so the focal length of the assembly of lenses, that is the assembly of lenses, three or four lenses, will behave like a concave lens. Now, if we talk about the power, so the total power will equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3. The net power, the total power of the three lenses will be equal to the sum of the algebraic sum of the individual power. Suppose its power is P1, P2, P3. So net power of the assembly of three lenses will be this P1 plus P2 plus P3, and P1, we put here P1, P2 and P3 with sign. Similarly for n lenses, we can extend it up to the n lenses. Sign here means P1 is power of the convex lens is positive, so put here plus sign. Concave lens negative, so put here negative sign. For again concave lens, so put here negative sign. So if we add, if the power comes out to be positive, then the नेट पावर इज पॉजिटिव मीन्स दैट द असेंबली ऑफ लेंसेज आर बिहेविंग लाइक अ कॉन्वेक्स लेंस. इफ द नेट पावर इज कमिंग आउट टू बी नेगेटिव इट मीन्स दैट द असेंबली ऑफ लेंसेज आर बिहेविंग लाइक अ कॉनकेव लेंस. Okay, thank you. This way this chapter is completed. Now we'll do the numericals on the next one.